take this to Tuhin Sinha. Tuhin, if you can, give us your perspective. The farmers are all set to protest in front of the parliament. They've been denied permission, but they say that this is symbolic. They will protest no matter what, even if they are arrested. They're not going to take the option of Delhi police giving them an alternate protest site.
I think, first of all, it will be incorrect to call these anarchists farmers. The farmers of this country are diligently working in their farms across the country. And the very fact that India has continuously over the last 1 year and more seen record agricultural outputs shows that the real farmers of the country are working in their farmlands. Now, I want to point this out to you that in January, after 11 rounds of discussions with representatives of farmers, so finally, the bill was put on hold for 18 months. So what are these anarchists protesting against? Are they protesting against their own ignorance, or do they deliberately want to trigger another COVID explosion? Besides, Tikri border is also known for multiple molestations of women who went there to support these agitations. Why are we not talking about that? And Congress, mind you, has a devious attitude. It supports anything that is wrong in the country. Why has the Congress ever spoken till now about the restrictions being waived in Kerala, which is reporting 16,000 cases every day?
Here, the farmers, Tuhin, say they claim that this is their livelihood. Yes, life is important. The coronavirus pandemic is raging, but their demands have been made at least for the last 8 months. They've been seated in protest, and they're worried that this will take away all their livelihood. It's as good as life and death situation for them as well.
On the contrary, as you would know, for the first time, MSP has been directly transferred to the accounts and record amounts have been transferred to both farmers of Haryana and Punjab. And most of them are happy. It's a minuscule proportion. The Rakesh Tikayats of the world, I don't know what shield they have against COVID, but they are putting the lives of other farmers at risk. Besides, as you know, for 18 minutes, the entire act is put on hold. So this is the time when they can piece their points up at all. So what are they protesting against if not ignorance?
Can I come in? See, the problem is, Nabila, they don't trust this government. He said it's put on hold. After 18 months, the farm laws will be, again, it'll come up, it's enacted and they will let it happen. Why they don't believe them? Because the Prime Minister of India said by 2022, he's going to double farm income. That is in 1 year, which is not going to happen. Before, in 2014, he said MSP will be cost plus 50%. In 2015, they go to Supreme Court and said, we cannot do it. So how do you, then they said, we will, farm loans will be waived. In 2017, Mr. Jaitley says in Parliament, we cannot waiver farm loans. The Congress party in 2008 wavered 70,000 crore of farm loans. That is what it is. There's a trust deficit. They believe our Congress party, but they do not trust this government. Also, let's not forget.
Shama and Tuhin, we know that this is a debate that's been raging in time and again. Discussions have failed for this exact reason. Let's cut down straight to the fact that we're looking at a pandemic. The Kavad Yatra was called off. Coming down straight to the fact that the Uttar Pradesh called off the Kavad Yatra. That's also a congregation. Haven't we learned lessons from the second wave of the COVID pandemic? At a time like this, isn't this the duty of the opposition to advise the farmers to ensure that they don't congregate?
Let me tell you, Nabila, you are upset about something. We have petrol prices, people do not have food. The petrol prices, there is inflation of 6%. There is retail inflation, all sorts of inflation in this country. People have nothing on there. There is COVID, they have lost jobs. Let me finish. I haven't interrupted you, Tuhin. When such an interesting, nobody, of course, they are protesting because the Prime Minister of India is not listening to them. It's a democracy. They do not want, they have lost more than 200 lives. Has the Prime Minister said a single word on that? Why does not the Prime Minister invite them and have a word with them, discuss it? And then, of course, there will be a solution, just like the gentleman
said. You should have dealt with this crisis much earlier. Why leave it till the pandemic and on? Why is there no consensus? At least for the sake of the pandemic, something should have come as a result.
Why does the Prime Minister need to sit into everything? We have had 11 rounds of discussions with the farmer representatives, and most of them were very friendly and cordial discussions. Most of their concerns were laid. As for the MSP is concerned, for the last 50 years it has existed, but it can't be given litigatory status because, we don't want, every issue to be mired in litigation. The country needs to move ahead. But let's come back to the pandemic. Does the Congress support these agitations? Punjab had the highest CFR rate during the second wave. Do you support that? That is the moot question.
Shama, question to you.
I want to ask him, Will you remove these laws? These people have been protesting. When will Mr. Modi talk to these farmers?
These laws
when
have
will
been
he condole the 200 and above deaths in the first
time
after you?
Anarchists can't have a control
do you
all the
ask
time
the
over
farmers?
Laws which have been passed in Parliament. That will be set a very wrong precedent. And these are the laws which Congress has been championing over many decades.
To the farmers,
but
the black laws have to go. They have to go. And also the Kavar Yatra was stopped because the Supreme Court asked them to. It is not the UP government. The central government, Mr. Modi, did not say
so
anything about
the, as the primary opposition in Kerala, have you asked the Kerala government to not to remove restrictions for EAT? As the primary
Sorry?
Opposition in Kerala, have you once asked the Kerala government to not remove restrictions for
EAT? That a two-day complete lockdown, Shava, the restriction is going to be lifted only ahead of Bakrid to allow festivities to carry out. You have Sabarimala also now allowing 10,000 odd visitors. Has the Congress Party as an opposition in Kerala spoken with conviction against those rules?
This is the duplicity of the Congress Party.
Eid al-Fitr, which was just 2 months back after Ramadan, nobody congregated for your kind information. You had the Kumbh. So please don't keep blaming the other part, the minorities all the time.
16,000 cases are being reported daily, one-third of the total number in the country. 10% TPR after 4 consistent months. Does that not bother the Congress Party as the main opposition party in Kerala? Rahul Gandhi is an MP from Kerala. Does it not bother him at all?
But I want to know, why are you letting our farmers die? When will you talk to our annadatas? That is what we want to know. You have
rendered... All right, let me bring in... Shama, hold on. I'll bring in Chaudhary Sawit Malik.
You have...